बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी शैल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द वेरियस टेक्निक्स टू कैलकुलेट द एरिया एंड वॉल्यूम ऑफ अ गिवन सर्वे स्कीम। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद अ फॉर्मल इंट्रोडक्शन। इट इज ऑफन नेसेसरी टू कंप्यूट द एरिया ऑफ अ ट्रैक्ट ऑफ लैंड विच मे बी रेगुलर और इरेगुलर इन शेप। लैंड इज ऑर्डिनरी bought and sold based on cost per unit area. To compute the volumes of earthwork to be cut or filled in planning a civil engineering project, it is necessary to compute the areas of different sections separately. Okay. In SI units, the area is measured in square meters, hectares or square kilometers. Here you can see there are number of methods by which you can easily calculate the area of a given scheme. Which method is used for your given area is depending upon many factors. So according to the given site conditions, you will decide that which of the method should be deployed and is easily implemented on the given area. For example, here you can see there is a first main category. You can calculate the area using field notes. Okay, then from plotted plan, area of closed traverse, instrumental and graphical methods. From the field notes, there is an offset method to calculate the area of a given survey scheme. We have already discussed offset method to calculate the area of the scheme in second or I think third lecture. We have detailed it and discussed, and we also solved some existing numerical problems related to the offsets. The second main category is from plotted plan you can calculate the area. Now in this method, if the boundary of the area is irregular, then all these methods can be applied to calculate the area. First one is trapezoidal rule, the second one is Simpson's rule, mid ordinate rule, average ordinate rule, and area of parcel with circular boundaries. Okay, third main category is area of closed traverse. So if you are dealing with an area which is actually a closed traverse, as we have discussed in previous lectures, so for the closed traverse, to calculate the area of the traverse, you can use any of these methods, which are the most famous is coordinates method, and the other methods are meridian distance method, double meridian distance method, double parallel distance method, departure and latitude method. The next broad category is instrumental and graphical methods. In this category, you can see counting coordinate squares by scaled length, by digitizing coordinates, by the planimeter. Planimeter is a simple instrument that is used to calculate the area using the plan or the map. So if you have only paperwork, you can calculate the area by using the sheets using planimeter. Other is the optical polar planimeter, and by using different types of software. So all these are methods used to calculate the area of the survey scheme. For regular figures, two most common methods are mathematical formulae and method of coordinates, and for irregular figures, trapezoidal and Simpson's rule. This is a typical picture of a digital planimeter. Okay, this is optical polar planimeter. If you are dealing with some regular figures like triangle, square, rectangle or any other regular shape, you can simply put the values, length of the side, into these formulae and get your required area. Okay, all these are different types of regular shapes having different area of cross sections. but not in reality actually these kind of regular figures exist. In field, you are always dealing with some irregular figures or irregular boundaries. Areas by methods of coordinates. In this figure, you can see that there is a closed traverse with five different stations is shown with the numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If the perpendicular is drawn from all these stations to the x-axis, all of these perpendiculars will be termed as the station coordinates. Okay. Now, if I am talking about this station line 1 and A, you can see this dotted line, this is Y1. You can name this line between the 2 and B station as Y2. Similarly, Y3, Y4 and Y5 will represent the perpendicular drawn from the station 3, 4 and 5 respectively up to the x-axis. By labeling the same traverse, you can see x1, x2, 3, 4, 5 are the horizontal distances from the y-axis as origin up to the stations A, B, C, D and E respectively. Similarly, y1, y2, y3, y4 and y5 are the perpendiculars drawn from the station A, B, C, D and E respectively up to the x-axis. By using this simple cross multiplication, you can easily get the area of the closed traverse. Okay. So this is how we are dealing with the area by method of coordinates. If there are irregular areas, the graphical method can be used. It is actually the estimated method. It will not give you the accurate value of the area. Estimate the area using a square grid made up of many 1 cm square as shown in figure. Okay, each grid, each square box is representing an area equivalent to 1 cm square. So this shaded, yellow shaded figure is actually representing the area of the scheme which we want to calculate. Okay, there are, you can see, 12 number of ticks. So this area will be approximately 12 cm square, although it is very different from the actual value of 12 cm square, but it is an approximated value. The next method is trapezoidal rule. Okay, here you can see the survey line is shown, which is actually the straight line. Okay, and then there exists a boundary which is not linear. Okay, so we can say that it is an irregular figure with one side as a straight line and the actually existing boundary with irregular behavior. Okay, to calculate the area between this irregular boundary and this straight survey line, we can use the technique of trapezoidal rule. We simply divide all this area into a number of small trapezoids. The trapezoids are named as 1, 2, 3, up to 6. Okay. Where small b is the interval distance between the offsets. H1, H2, H3, up to H7 are the offsets taken from the survey line up to the boundary line. And the horizontal distances, as you can see, they are all equal to B. Okay, B is the regular interval. It can be regular interval or it can be of different value. But in this figure, you can see that B is equal. What does it mean? That at equal distance, the intervals are taken or the offsets are taken. So from figure we can conclude that as we are going to increase the number of offsets taken from the chain edge or the main survey line, our area will become more and more accurate and vice versa. as you can see in this figure, the smaller trapezoidal areas are given named as 1, 2, 3 up to 6. So we separately calculate the area of the trapezoid, and then by summing up all these small areas, we will get the total area of the trapezoidal shape. So this is the basic formula: area of a trapezoid equal to H1 plus H2, which are the two offsets, divided by 2, it is indicating the average portion, multiplied by the common interval. Similarly, for area of trapezoid 2, H2 plus H3 over 2 into B up to the last area of trapezoid. Okay, this slide is actually representing the isolated areas for each of the small trapezoid. Now, if we sum up, we can get a generic formula for that. We will see it in the next slide. Now, the Simpson's one-third rule, which is also called the parabolic rule, there is a slight distance between the trapezoidal area method and the Simpson one-third method. The basic difference is that in the trapezoidal rule, we were dealing the irregular boundary as a straight line for the small trapezoid. Okay, but in this method, as you can see, if we talk about the area AEGB, okay, I repeat, if we talk about the area AEG and B, you can see that the line DG is taken as a parabola, but not the straight line. The dotted line is indicating that if we would use the trapezoidal method, we would follow the line BC as dotted line. But when we are talking about the Simpson's formula, if you see its derivation and geometry, you will eventually come to know that this BG line and GC line is taken as it is, as that is why it is known as the parabolic formula, because we are dealing it as a curve. Okay, same is the case with that. If we are going to increase the number of offsets, we are actually increasing the accuracy of the area calculation. Now, small b, which I talked in the previous slide, I named it the small b as the interval distance. It is also known as the intercept. Okay, two names for the same term. You can use any name. Okay, here is the note that you can use the Simpson's one-third rule only when there are odd number of offsets are available. Odd numbers means that definitely number of intercepts will be even. So for odd number of terms, this formula is applicable. Now let us see into the detail. First of one is the trapezoidal rule, in which we divide the whole area into a number of small trapezoids. Trapezoidal rule say that to the sum of first and last ordinates, which is also known as offset, add twice the sum of intermediate ordinates. Multiply the total sum thus obtained by the common distance between the ordinates. One half of this product will give you the required area. Mathematically speaking, area will be equal to B by 2, where B is the interval of the offset. It can be a common interval, regular or irregular interval. And all the H terms are representing the number of offsets. So the area will be B by 2 into the first offset. By definition, I am talking, H1 is the first offset plus last offset plus 2 times the sum of all the remaining other offsets. Okay, I am repeating. If you read the definition once again, it is the mathematical representation of the same definition. B by 2, where B is the interval of the offset, into the first offset plus the last ordinate plus 2 times the sum of all the remaining offsets. Okay, this is the total formula of the to calculate the area of trapezoidal rule. Second one is the Simpson's rule, which is also known as parabolic rule. It states that to the sum of first and last ordinates, add twice the sum of remaining odd ordinates and four times the sum of all even ordinates. Multiply the total sum thus obtained by one third of the common distance between the ordinates, and the result will give you the required area. Simply speaking, b by 3 into x plus 2o plus 4e is its main formula, where x is the sum of the first and last ordinates, o is the sum of remaining odd ordinates, and e is the sum of remaining even ordinates. By expanding this formula, we will get b by 3, where b is the common interval, into sum of first and last ordinate, which are h1 plus hn, plus 4 times the sum of all remaining even ordinates, plus 2 times the sum of all the remaining or odd ordinates. So this is the total formula to calculate the area using Simpson's rule. Then comes the average ordinate rule. It states that the ordinates are drawn and scaled at each of the points of division of the baseline. The average of these ordinates multiplied by the length of the baseline will give you the required area. Mathematically, area will be equal to, now offsets in this case are replaced by O0, O1, O2, which were previously named as H1, H2, H3. These are the same thing. In this formula, we are representing H as O. Okay, O is representing the number of offsets. O1 plus O2 plus O3 up to ON are the all number of ordinates divided by N plus 1 multiplied by L, where L is the length of the baseline, total length of the baseline. Small n is representing the number of equal parts in which baseline is divided, which is again n is replaced by b. Okay, the same thing. Next comes the mid-ordinate rule. In this method, ordinates are measured at midpoints of each division and area is then calculated. It is very simple. Its area is equal to h1 plus h2 plus up to hn, all the number of offsets, multiplied by the common distance between these offsets. Let me maximize this. So this is how we draw the figure. Here you can see this is the main survey line, which is a straight line, and opposite to that you can see an irregular boundary line. Okay, d is representing the common distance between the points of divisions. 1, 2, 3, 4 are representing number of divisions, points of divisions actually, in which the baseline is divided. But instead you are taking the offsets at these division levels. We are taking the offsets at the midway in between these divisions. H1 is the first offset as indicated in this formula, which is exactly in the center of 0 and 1 point. Okay. Similarly, H2 is the offset which is the midway between the 1 and 2 points of division. So in this technique, the only difference is that we are taking the offsets the midway between the points of division. Now these were the some of the methods used to calculate the area. Let us solve some of the examples to clear your concept. The first problem is based on the Simpson's and trapezoidal rule, in which the offset interval is same and even number of offsets exist. Okay, the statement says that a series of offsets were taken from a chain line to a curved boundary line at intervals of 10 meters in the following order. Here this point is noted that we have drawn and discussed this figure in the mid-ordinate rule. The same figure will be drawn by using these offsets and changes. If you want to draw, it will be helpful for you to solve the question. Okay, the statement also verifies that the same figure will be drawn by using the given data, in which one line is a straight line and the other is a curved boundary line, just as we discussed in the previous method. Okay, the regular interval is also provided to you, which is 10 meters. Okay, the requirement is that you have to find the area by using trapezoidal and Simpson's rule. So let us start with the trapezoidal rule first. Let me remind you again that trapezoidal rule is a rule used to calculate the area of the scheme by dividing the whole area to be surveyed into a number of small trapezoids. Then by adding all these small trapezoids, you will get the total area of the scheme. So the simple formula for the area of scheme in the trapezoidal rule is b by 2 into h1 plus hn, which are the first and last ordinates, plus 2 into the sum of all the remaining ordinates. So substituting all these values, the value of b is equal to 10, which is the regular interval as given in the question as 10 meter. Okay, 10 by 2 into the first and last ordinates. Here you can see that the value of first and last ordinates for the offsets h1 and h8 are both are 0. So that is why we substitute the value of h1 and hn as 0 and 0 plus 2 times into the all remaining offsets. So we substitute the values as they are. H2 is 2.82, here you can see 2.82, similarly 3.96 plus 6.42, all the remaining ordinates. So by simplifying, we get the area as 359.6 square meters. Now proceeding towards the second method, which is required as Simpson rule. Now the point here is to be noted that the Simpson rule, as we already discussed, exists only for the odd number of terms. But in our question, we are given with the 8 terms. Let us see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 terms. So we are dealing with the even number of terms, but the Simpson rules say that the area to be surveyed by using Simpson rule must be having odd number of offsets. So the technique we shall use is that we first solve the given problem for the 7 terms, and the remaining last term will be solved by the trapezoidal rule. Okay, what does it mean? Let me explain by using some. Okay, there was no issue in solving the problem by using trapezoidal rule, but we are dealing with the Simpson rule, which implies that odd number of terms must be given to you. So we will first deal with these first seven terms. Okay, 7 is the odd number. We shall solve for the 7 terms. Then we shall add by using H7 and H8 term using trapezoidal rule. Then by adding these 1 and these 2 products, by adding both of them, we will get the required answer. It is very simple. Let us see how it works. So starting, the area using the Simpson's rule is equal to b by 3 into first summation of first and last ordinate. Here you can see h1 plus hn minus 1 is given, but not hn is given. Okay, it's by definition, the Simpson rule is to the sum of first and last ordinates add the other ordinates. Okay, but here is a difference, as we are dealing it with the even number of terms. That is why last term is not used, but it is the second last term, seventh term, h1 plus hn minus 1 term, plus 4 into all the remaining other even ordinates, plus 2 into all the remaining other odd ordinates. Okay, this is formula up to this point is applicable for 7 terms, odd number of terms. Plus, for the last term, we shall solve it as b by, it should be 2, b by 2, as we are now discussing the trapezoidal rule. So, according to trapezoidal rule, b by 2, this term should be, into second last term plus last term divided by 2. By substituting the values 10 by 3, 10 is the common interval, into first offset was 0, as you can see in the question. Plus 5.25, it is the second last term, seventh term. Plus 4 into 2.82, which is the second term, plus 6.4 to 4 term, sixth term, plus 2 into all the remaining odd ordinates. Plus, now comes the trapezoidal part, 10 by 2, 5.25 plus 0. Okay, by solving all these calculations, area will be equal to 369.42 square meters. So, there will always be a slight difference between the value of areas calculated using different types of methods. So, you should not be confused if there is a slight difference between different method values. But remember, Simpson's rule is most accurate of all the methods. Now, let us try to solve the second example in which the statement is given, following offsets were taken from the survey line to a hedge. Here you can see in the first row, distance is given, or you can say change is given, starting from the 0, 5, 10, 15 up to 70, and offsets are given, which are also known as ordinates, as at 0 change offset was 3.29, at 5 meter change the offset was observed as 4.05, and similarly up to the last term. Okay, this is the given data. Now we are required to solve this method using trapezoidal and Simpson rule again. Okay, now if you have noticed that the distance given to you in the example having a common distance of 5 meter interval up to this change of 20 meters. After 20 meter change, you can see that the common interval is changed from 5 meter to 10 meters now. So 20, 30, 40, these are the readings having a common interval of 10 meter. After 40 meter interval, again the interval is changing from 10 to 15 meters. For the last three terms, you can observe that the 15 meter common interval is selected now. So how to solve it? We shall solve it in three segments. Whenever the common interval is changing its value, you should calculate the area separately for that portion. So technically speaking, let me draw this. We divide this question into three segments. This is the first segment, I call it 1. Okay. This is the second segment in which the common distance is changing as 10 meters, and this will be the third portion for last three terms in which the interval is changing from 10 to 15 meters. So let us solve all these three segments separately and try to calculate the values. Now first of all, using trapezoidal rule, area is first divided into three sections wherever the common interval is changing. So A1 is the area for the first section. According to the formula, 5 is the common interval divided by 2 into the sum of first and last ordinate. Here the last ordinate is fifth term, which is 4.76, remember. Okay, plus 2 into all the remaining other ordinates, plus 2.5 into this. We are getting the area of the A1 is equal to 100.275 square meters. Now coming towards the second segment, A2 is equal to Here you can see the value is changed from 5 to 10. The same formula implies that 98 square meter is the result. For A3, now 15 by 2 into first and last term plus remaining ordinates, and the answer is 113.025. Now the total area will be the summation of all these segments, A1 plus A2 plus A3, which is giving you the value of 311.3 square meters. By calculating the area using the same method, we are now using the Simpson's rule. Again, we are dividing the total area into the three segments depending upon their common interval. For the first area, 5 by 3 into 3.29 plus 4.76, which are the first and fifth terms, plus 4 times the summation of all the remaining even ordinates and the 2 times all the remaining odd ordinates. By simplifying, we will get the answer as 99.52. I am not discussing A2 and A3 because these are the same. Okay, so this is the final answer, 314.47 square meter. Now proceeding to the next example, which is based on the average ordinate rule, in which a regular interval is given. The following offsets were taken from a survey line to the hedge. Again, change and ordinates are given to you. Change is starting from 0, 10, 5, 10, up to 70. Okay, these are the values of the previous example as it is. But now we are trying to solve it using average ordinate rule. The average ordinate rule says that area is equal to summation of all the offsets, okay, divided by number of intervals multiplied by the total length of the survey line. So for this formula, by adding all the offsets, as you can see, multiply by 4 into 5 is actually the total length of the survey line. Where does it come? We are talking about the A1. Let me draw it again. We are talking about the A1 area, which is starting from the term 0 up to 20. So for A1, first term will be 0 and the last term will be 20. Okay. This is also giving you the value of total length of the change from 0 to 20 meters. That is why we are substituting the value of 4 into 5, which is equal to 20 meters. Okay. 5 is the length of a single interval, as you can see, 0 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15, a difference of 5, which is 5 meters, and the number of intervals are 4. Okay. This is the first interval from 0 to 5. This is the second interval from 5 to 10. The third interval from 10 to 15. Fourth interval from 15 to 20. So there are 4 intervals and length of each interval is 5. We are getting the value of 20 meters as total length of the change for the area of A1. Fine. Now similarly, the same rule implies for A2. The same rule will be applied, and similarly for A3, by adding all these areas you will get the answer of 303.42 square meters. So this was all about the average ordinate rule. Now proceeding towards the next example, the following offsets were taken from a chain line to an irregular boundary line at an interval of 10 meters. Okay, here offsets are given to you as 0, 2.5, 3.5, 5, 4.6, 3.2 meters, and 0. And the regular interval is also given to you, which is 10 meters. equal regular interval. You are required to compute the area between the chain line, irregular boundary line, and the end offsets by using mid-ordinate rule. Okay, this is another method, mid-ordinate rule. We simply take the midpoint between the two offsets as our required ordinates. So, I highly recommend that you should draw the figure first for all these methods so that you would get the better idea of understanding. Now, the first step is that using mid-ordinate rule, we must calculate the midpoints between the points of division. Okay, points of division exist at 0 meter, 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, and up to so on. Okay, so we should calculate the midway between. So how to take the average? 0, which is the first term plus second term, divided by 2, and you will get the mid ordinate. Okay, this is h2, 2.5 plus 3.5 divided by 2. This is the mid ordinate between the stations 1 and 2. Okay, similarly for the same six offsets, you can use the same method. Now we have calculated from H1 to H6 the mid ordinates in between the irregular boundary. Now the total area will be equal to, this is the formula, the common interval multiplied by the sum of mid ordinates. 10 into 18.80 is equal to 188 square meters, very simple. The next example says that following perpendicular offsets were taken from a chain line to a hedge. Chain edge is given as 0, 6.2, 15.4, 27.2, 40.6. And the values of offsets against these chain edges are also given to you. Here you can see that there is no common interval between any of the offsets. Here random points are selected throughout the chain edge to get the different values of offsets. First of all, you should draw the figure for this and then solve it by using trapezoidal rule. Okay, H1 is the first offset, which is equal to 6.52. H2 is the second offset, equal to 7.34, up to H5. Five offsets are given. Now D1, it is the common, it is the interval between the two offsets. How is it calculated? 6.2, the second point at chain edge, minus the first point at chain edge. 6.2 minus 0 is equal to 6.2. Now we want to calculate the interval between the second and third offset. What will be formula? 15.4 minus 6.2, it will be equal to 9.2 meters. Similarly for D3 and D4, by adding all these individually calculated trapezoidal areas, we will get the required answer, which is equal to 250 square meters. It is simply exactly same as we have discussed in trapezoidal rule, but a slight difference is that there exists irregular interval. Okay, now let us proceed towards the volume computations. Now the second part of this lecture, so we are talking about the volume computations. Here you can see a trapezoid which can be a canal channel. Okay, it is the diagram of a channel. In this you can see the terms as small b is representing the width of the channel. Okay, h is the height of the channel. S ratio 1 is the slope. Okay, the inclined line is indicating the slope. So let us discuss first the geometry behind it. Starting that, finding x using slow. We are having this width of the channel, the bottom width, which is equal to B, but we do not have the value of upper width. Okay, so how to calculate if we are able to get the value of X? So by adding X both left and right sides of the B, we will get the complete width, top width of the channel. So we can calculate the top width of the channel using this slope. If we know the slope, we can calculate the value of top width. There is a little geometry behind this. First of all, you should know that S ratio 1 is indicating horizontal over vertical. S is the horizontal and Y is the vertical component of this slope, which is represented as S ratio 1, horizontal over vertical. If we take the inverse of this, it will become vertical over horizontal as given in the next step. This is vertical over horizontal. So S ratio 1 will become 1 ratio S. Here you can see vertical over horizontal, we can write it as 1 over S. Okay, now you are looking at this triangle. This triangle is actually the combination of two small triangles. Okay, let me isolate these two small triangles for your clearance of the concept. Okay, first triangle is this one, it is H, and this is X. Okay, triangle number 1 and this is triangle number 2. The combination of 1 and 2 is this triangle which is shown in the given figure. So in the second triangle you can see vertical line is indicating H and horizontal as X. And for second triangle, as we have discussed that S is the horizontal and vertical is 1. Fine. These are the two similar triangles which are merged to give you the single triangle as shown in this figure. Okay. I am repeating, in first triangle the horizontal distance is indicated by S and the vertical as 1. So the slope will be S ratio 1. And in the second triangle horizontal distance is X, which is unknown to us, and vertical distance is H, which we calculate, which is actually the offset. Okay, so by using these similar triangles, now you can see we have this formula. 1 ratio S, which is vertical over horizontal, is equal to H over X. This is nothing but just using the similarity of two triangles in the same formula. 1 over S is equal to H over X using triangles or the figures 1 and 2. Okay, which is further equal to tan theta. It is verified. By using this formula, if you cross multiply the different terms, we will get the product as X is equal to SH after simple cross multiplication. Okay, fine for
now. Let us erase this little bit.
We have now X is equal to SH, where X is this distance as indicated in the figure, S is the slope, and H is the height of the offset. Again, there are two methods to calculate the total volume of the given survey scheme. The first is the trapezoidal rule, or you can also say it average area and rule, in which volume is equal to D by 2, where D is the offset interval. Okay, into the to the sum of first and last area. A is indicating the cross-sectional area.
in reality the cross sectional area lies like this one. This is cross sectional area of the trapezoid represented by A1, and this is the area represented by the trapezoid A2. Similarly, if you proceed toward in the longitudinal direction lengthwise, A3, A4, A5 will come in your direction of proceeding of survey. A3, A4 and up to so on. Fine. So, according to formula, volume is equal to D by 2 into cross-sectional area 1 plus cross-sectional area, last cross-sectional area AN plus 2 times the sum of all other cross-sectional areas. Now, second method is prismoidal formula. Let me erase this first. For prismoidal formula, V is equal to D by 3 into first and last areas of cross sections plus 4 times the remaining even areas of cross sections and the 2 times the remaining odd areas of cross sections. Let us try to solve some example of this. An embankment of width 10 meters and side slope of 1:5:1 is required to be constructed on a ground which is already leveled in the direction of the center line. The central heights are at 20 meter intervals having values. So this is the given data. For width, which was represented as this small b, width is given as 10 meters. Side slope is also given, S value of S is equal to 1.5. Central heights, also known as the offsets H1, H2, H3, at 20 meter regular intervals, which is the value of D, small d, as indicated in this formula, D, 20 meters. These are the given values. Values of offsets at the place where cross-sectional areas are calculated are 0.8, 1.2, 2.25. These are all the value of offsets H1, H2 up to last H. You are required to calculate the volume of earthwork by using trapezoidal rule and prismoidal formula. So first of all, we can simplify the figure and then we can use it in volume formula directly. This is the given data. B is equal to 10 meters, S is equal to 1.5, D is equal to 20 meters. Cross-sectional areas can be calculated by simplifying the formula. Let us first simplify the formula. This is the embankment, figure of an embankment. What is an embankment and where it is used, how it is used, how it looks like in reality, you can just Google it and see what is actually the embankment is and in which kind of projects we use the embankment. This is a typical cross-sectional figure of an embankment. Top width is given as 10 meters, 1:5:1. This is same as the top width, 10 meters. Here you can see we are writing this SH. Okay, to calculate the cross sectional area of the embankment, we need this portion as written as SH and SH. So how this SH comes, we have already discussed it, that X is equal to SH. You can again derive this formula by splitting this combined triangle into two isolated triangles and then cross multiply this formula and getting this answer. Or the second method is, instead you can simply use this formula as it is, X is equal to SH. So this portion, horizontal portion, is equal to X, which is equal to SH.
I'm directly entering the value of SH at both sides. So first of all, area of embankment in cross section. Now we are going to calculate the area of cross section. This is a typical trapezoidal figure. So simple formula of the trapezoid is equal to sum of parallel sides divided by 2 multiplied by the perpendicular side. This is what the formula of area of trapezium or trapezoid. So according to this given data and this figure, first sum up all the two parallel sides SB plus SH plus B plus SH. Okay, this one divided by 2 multiplied by the perpendicular distance, in our case it is H, the offset height. By simplifying this 2B plus 2SH over 2 into H, we will get this formula for the area of cross section, B plus SH into H. You can also put directly all your given data in the basic formula of area of trapezium, but it will take so much time and the calculation will be lengthy. But if you feel comfortable and you have enough time to serve, then this will be the this can be your option. You can go with it, but I am simplifying the formula to save my time and energy. B plus SH into H is the simplest formula. You can further simplify it by opening this bracket and multiplying by H. So we will now isolately calculate all the cross sectional areas by this formula one by one. A1 is equal to B1 plus SH1 plus H1 is equal to, now putting the values, you can see B is same throughout. So B1, B2, B3 is equal to 10 throughout according to the given statement. S is also constant, which is given in the question. Slope is 1.5 multiplied by, only the changing value is of H, which is your offset. H1 is 0.8. Substituting the value, we just got the formula, area of the first cross section as 8.96 square meters. A2, A3, A4, value of B and S will be constant throughout. The only value changing is, the only value changing is of H. Okay, by substituting the value of all the intercepts, we get the isolated areas as all shown. Okay, now according to the question, we should solve it by using trapezoidal rule and prismatic formula. So first, let us try to calculate the volume using trapezoidal rule by formula 20 into 2 multiplied by 8.96, which is the first area of cross section, plus 10.22, which is the last area of cross section, plus 2 times the summation of all other areas of cross section, and we will get the answer as 26.8 square meters. Now implementing the second technique, which is prismoidal formula, 20 by 3 into first area of cross section plus last area of cross section plus 4 into even areas of cross section and 2 into remaining odd areas of cross section, and we will get this answer as 2647.7 square meters. So this was all about trapezoidal and prismoidal formula. Another example is, embankment is to be raised. Calculate the earthwork required for an area with 20 meter width. Okay, width is given to you, 20 meters, it is actually the top width of the embankment. Distance change is given, 100, 105, 110, 115, 20, 25. Cross-sectional area at these changes, points are 3, 8, 13, 17, 23, 29 square meters. We have to calculate the volume by trapezoidal and prismoidal rule. Now, again, if you remember, to use the prismoidal formula, to calculate the volume. Number of offsets must be odd. Okay, there should be odd number of offsets. But in our case, we have 6 offsets, so it is even value. The same procedure as we discussed in Simpson's rule will be implemented in this Prismodel rule. We shall first solve the first 5 terms, and then for the last term we will use the trapezoidal formula again. Volume for the terms from 100 to 120, okay, second last term 120, is equal to 5/3 into first term plus last term plus 4 into even terms plus 2 into remaining odd terms. Area, volume is equal to, the unit of volume is mistakenly as written here as square meter. It is in cubic meters, okay. You should make correction. 253.33 square meters. V120 up to 125. Here we are using the trapezoidal formula. Simply the summation of two parallel sides, which is 23 plus 29, the second last and last cross sectional areas divided by 2 into 5, which is the distance between the last two cross sectional area values. It is 130 square meter. By adding these two values, we will get the volume as 383.33 cubic meters. By using trapezoidal rule, volume is equal to 5/2. It is very simple to the sum of first and last of area of cross sections. Add the two times sum of remaining areas of cross section, and we will get the final answer. So this was all about the area and volume calculation. There are a variety of other methods as well. By using any of the method, you can calculate the area. Whichever method is convenient to you, you can use any method in the field to calculate the area and volume of earthworks. Okay, that's all for today's lecture. Thank you very much.